Hi, good day to you. This is Mrs. Liao presenting to you Sec 3 Further Trigonometry. Now that you have mastered Sec 2 Trigo, let's move on to Sec 3. Let us look at 6.1, sine and cosine of obtuse angles. Obtuse angles are angles more than 90 degrees. So if I were to measure an angle from the x-axis, we will go anti-clockwise. Anti-clockwise in this direction, and let's say I want to obtain an obtuse angle. This will be an obtuse angle measured from x-axis in an anti-clockwise direction. Okay, so now let us look at this activity. Wow, what will be the ratio of obtuse angles? Okay, now let us look at the first 27 degrees angle. What will be the obtuse angle if theta is 27 degrees? It will be 153 degrees. If I were to key in sine theta, which is sine 27 degrees, I'm going to get 0.4540. Okay, so I'd like you to try this on your own. Use a calculator and compute. So you can either follow me or you can pause and fast forward and look at the final answer of all the values. Okay, now let us continue with sine 153 degrees. So this calculator works differently. We get the same answer. 0.4540. What about cosine theta? Cosine theta 27, because theta is 27 cosine, I get 0.8910. Now what about cosine 153 degrees? Let me look at 153 cosine. Negative 0.8910. Interesting, we have a negative sign here. Now let's look at the next one, 75 degrees. So if theta is 75, 180 degrees minus theta will give us 105. So first we look at sine theta. 75 sine, and we get 0.96 Now I move on to 105 sine, same, 0.9660. What about cosine? Now let's press cosine 75. You get 0.2588. What about cosine 105? What do you think we will get? 105 cosine, you're going to get negative. Negative 0.2588. Looks like the numbers are the same except there is a negative sign in front. Now, we will see the same pattern. Moving on to obtuse angles. So we are looking at 110. 180 minus 110 is 70 degrees. So now let me key in 110 sine. So I'll have 0.9. Okay, so this part. Sorry, let me rewrite this. This is 9397. Okay, so now let us key in Now 180 minus theta is 70, so we'll key in 70 sine. Ah, so you say answer. Okay, what about cosine? We're gonna key in cosine 110. 110 cosine. Negative 0.3420. Oh, we have noticed when it is cosine obtuse, it is negative. Now what about cosine acute? 70 cosine gives us a positive value. Positive value. What about the last column? 180 minus 136 is 44 degrees. So now let me first key in sine obtuse. 136 sine. Do we get a positive or negative value? Positive. 6947. And then what about sine 44, which is an acute value? Yes, same. Both are positive. So I hope by now you can see a pattern. When I key in cosine obtuse angle, we are expecting a negative value. A negative value. Then when we key in cosine obtuse angle 44, we're gonna get a positive value. So what does this activity tell us? When we have cosine obtuse, we get a negative value. Cosine acute is positive. And for both cosine, we will always get positive values for either obtuse or acute angle. Okay, so we are going to write down our observation. So what can we say about the relationship between sine theta and sine 180 degrees minus theta? We can conclude that sine theta is the same as sine 180 degrees minus theta, regardless whether theta is acute or obtuse. For cosine, cosine theta is equals to negative cosine 180 minus theta is equals to negative cosine 180 degrees minus theta. Alright? Yes, so this is what we can write. Or I can write it in another way. Or you can simply shift the negative sign to the other side and claim that cosine 180 degrees minus theta is the same as negative cosine theta. Alright? Yes. They are the same. So now, this statement says, if theta is acute, then both sine and cosine theta will be positive. Please highlight with me. And if 180 degrees minus theta is obtuse because theta is acute, then note the relationship. Then sine obtuse angle is positive, whereas cosine obtuse angle is negative. Cosine obtuse angle is negative. Let me use a circle to explain to you why. Now let's take a look at this circle. I'm going to enlarge this page and focus on this circle. Now let's say I have a point P on this circle drawn on the xy axis. So with the point P, the coordinates of P is xy. Theta is in the first quadrant, the first quarter of the circle starting from x-axis over here. So this is called the first quadrant. So now, if this is theta, then based on this angle in this right angle triangle. This is called the opposite, this is the adjacent, and this is the hypotenuse. So sine theta is going to be this value, which is y, over this hypotenuse is actually the radius of the circle r, y, which is positive, over r. What about cosine theta? Cosine is adjacent. This value here is read as x. On the point here, this is x. So it's x over hypotenuse radius r. I will also get positive value. So that's why cosine theta and sine theta will give me both the positive value. Now let us look at the obtuse angle. Obtuse angle, I've shown you just now, we measure from x-axis. We go anti-clockwise. So this angle here is obtuse. Now, how can we form a right angle triangle with an obtuse angle? That's not possible. So we are going to use a reference angle to help us decide which one is opposite, adjacent, and hypotenuse. So if this is 180 degrees minus theta, then this reference angle must be theta, because angles on the straight line forms 180 degrees. So from this angle, I'm going to label this as opposite, this is adjacent, and then we are going to have the radius as hypotenuse, r. This is r stated here, hypotenuse. Okay, so now let's take a look. Sine 180 degrees minus theta is obtuse. So we're going to use this theta to help us. It is going to be opposite. Now what's opposite? Opposite, this value here is y over radius r. Y over r giving us a positive value. What about cosine? Cosine 180 degrees minus theta is adjacent. Now let's take a look here. Adjacent, this value is at the negative side of the x-axis. So this value here is negative x. So negative x over r is giving us a negative value. That's why cosine, obtuse angle, cosine with an obtuse angle will give us a negative value. So this is what I'm trying to explain here. So what's the conclusion? The conclusion is, if theta is acute, let me use a blue pen. Then sine theta is going to be equals to sine 180 minus theta, which means sine obtuse equals to positive sine acute. What about cosine? Now let's take a look. So in general, cosine theta is going to be negative of cosine obtuse angle. Why is this so? It is because when we have cosine theta is being acute, but this value here is negative. So to make it positive, I have to add in a negative value. Okay, so this is going to be negative of a negative value that makes it positive. If you're still unsure, no worries. Now let us look at the next page to look at more examples. Okay, now that we are going to look at the ratio and find their values to 3SF. So let me use my calculator to help me again. Before that, can you predict what we'll get for 138 degrees in sine? Positive or negative? Yes, we'll get a positive value. So this is going to be the positive 0.670. Sorry, 669. 0.669. 669. policies to 3SF. Now taking a look at this, this is cosine obtuse. We expect a negative value. 1, 1, 2 cosine. Yes, get a negative value. Negative 0.374. Rounded up is a 5. It's a 5. 3SF. Alright? Okay, so now let's look at the example 2. We are going to find not the ratio now, but the angle. Possible values of theta from 0 to 180, which means it includes both the acute and obtuse. That means this range. Acute and obtuse. Okay, so now let's take a look. We are going to find theta for part A. We are going to find if sine theta is 0.4, theta will have to be sine inverse of 0.4. Let me try this out. 0.4 inverse. We get a 23.6 degree. 23.6 degree. 1 dps, but as we know, sine obtuse is also positive, so I also need to work this out, or let me write in the word or, theta is going to be the obtuse angle, 180 degrees minus 23.578. This, because it's working, we write in 3 dp, and final answer, we are going to get 156.4 degree, 1 dp. Now, please remember, if sine is positive, we are going to get either the acute or obtuse angle. Oh, why is Mrs. Del right here? This is acute. I want to write the word acute. C-U-T-E. Both answers. There are two answers. Now, let's look at part B. Part B says cosine theta is negative. So, what are we going to expect? Now, let me key this in. We are going to have a negative 0.925. Negative, yes, cosine inverse. Am I right? That's right, cosine inverse. We get an obtuse angle. And the calculator has shown us that if we have a negative value, we will get an obtuse angle, 0.7 to 1 dp. Yes? Alright. Now let's go on to part C. Looks like I don't have much space. I need to shift it down here. Yeah, okay. Part C. Again, it is cosine theta being a negative ratio. So what kind of angle are we expecting? Let me key this in. 0.061 negative. Oops. 0.061. Let me try again. Negative. No, this one? Yes. Cosine inverse. Yeah. More than 90. In fact, it is. And obtuse angle. So we have this is 0.51 dp. Alright.
Okay, now let's look at part D. This question. Do you think it has one or two answers? Sine theta is a positive value, so it can either be in the first quadrant, which is acute, or second quadrant, which is obtuse. So let me write sine inverse. Oh, actually, we don't have to do that. We just have to find sine inverse on the calculator. So let me press 0.8043 and sine inverse. So this is my answer. 53.5. That's my first answer. 53.5. Or don't forget. Always don't forget the obtuse angle. 53.4543, giving us 126.5 degrees. 1 dp, alright. Okay, very good. We have 2 more examples to go. Now let me go back to the example 3. Okay, now we are looking at the fact that we know that cosine obtuse is negative of cosine acute. Cosine obtuse is going to be the negative of cosine acute. Alright, this works as well. So now let's look at part A. Write down cosine angle ACD. ACD is over here. Since I know that cosine obtuse is equal to cosine acute, I need to find what is cosine angle ACB first. Alright, in fraction. So this is the angle we are looking at first. This is going to be adjacent. And this is going to be the hypotenuse. So cosine angle ACB is going to be 8 over 10, which is 4/5. So which means, so cosine angle ACD is negative of cosine angle ACB. Therefore, this is going to be negative 4/5. This is an important example where testers and examiners will always ask frequently. Okay, now let's look at part B. Calculate the perpendicular distance from B to AC. Where is B? B is here to AC. Okay, perpendicular distance, here we go. Let me draw that again. Perpendicular. Alright, I think just leave it perpendicular. How shall we find this? First, we must understand that if we were to look at this triangle from the base, which is 10, and perpendicular height, let's call this x, then we can actually use the area of triangle to find what is x. Now let me do part B here. Let x be the perpendicular distance from B to AC. Okay, so we can write half times base times height is equals to the perspective, where you have half times base of 8 and height of 6. Yeah, so what do we have? Alright, so we have the half on both sides, where you can cancel. So we have 10x is equals to 48. X must be equals to 4.8 cm.
I hope you know this trick and you can apply it during your homework and then your test. So now let's look at the last example. Alright, is this a case of where you have the cosine obtuse equals to cosine, cosine obtuse equals to negative cosine acute again. Let's take a look. We need to look at A, tangent angle BAC. BAC is over here. This is part A. So now let's take a look at A. Opposite over adjacent. Tangent angle BAC is opposite 5 over 12. Done. What about cosine? Angle ACD. This one. Okay, obviously this is an obtuse angle. I need to make use of the acute angle to relate to the cosine obtuse. So first I must find cosine ACB. Cosine acute ACB, which is adjacent over hypotenuse, the T. So therefore, cosine obtuse is equals to negative cosine acute, which is negative 5 over 30. Alright, that's it for obtuse angles of sine and cosine. Please look at your Sec 3 textbook and do these sums as homework. Alright, good day. Bye.